Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Jasleen Arora, consultant neurologist and pediatrician at Amandi Medicity Hospital, Amritsar. Today, I want to talk to you about the third wave of coronavirus. Third wave is most likely going to affect all of us, maybe in the coming months, and when it will peak, no one knows. The epidemiologist says that if we continue to indulge in social gatherings and have social outings, the third wave may come very soon upon us, maybe by the end of August or September. But if we follow COVID-appropriate behavior, maintain social distance, and have frequent hand washing and appropriate use of masks, we can delay it and prolong it. And we need to delay and prolong it so that all our healthcare system, all the people that who have been severely affected in the second wave of the coronavirus, and all the families who have been disrupted by this behavior, can have time to recover and recuperate. So, following COVID-appropriate behavior is very important. Many parents say that we have got the vaccination done, we are fully immunized, the coronavirus cannot affect us now. We don't know for sure that the recent mutations that occur in this third wave of coronavirus, how is it going to affect the immunized individuals? Also, the seroprotectivity rate from the vaccination ranges from 60 to 95%. So, it is not 100%. You can still be affected with COVID, and the symptoms may be severe or may be mild also in a vaccinated individual. Going to schools, going to malls, going to marriage parties, going to overcrowded places exposes us to the COVID wave, COVID third wave. See, when we are moving out, we are not following COVID appropriate behavior, the COVID virus gets time to mutate in every person that is there. So, there are more chances that the third wave or the new variants of COVID will come, and they might create more, even more waves after the third wave also. So even after vaccination, even after you're being safe from coronavirus, it's very important. It's very important that you follow your hand sanitization, follow wearing mask, appropriate mask, and follow social distancing. So the next question comes about going to school. As a parent, it is my opinion that if you think you have trained your baby appropriately in following COVID-appropriate behavior, your baby is able to wear masks properly, having a proper nasal and oral seal, with frequent hand sanitization methods and your social distancing, then it might be safe to send your kid to school. But if your kid is very small and he is not able to wear masks properly and does not know when and how to sanitize their hands, be it by hand washing or using hand sanitizer, then it might be safer if we keep our kids home. But in the end, it's the parents' decision which they have to take mutually with the teachers and amongst themselves. So what else can we do to keep our kids safe? Make sure that you give them healthy balanced diet so that their immune system is strong. They're having plenty of physical activity at home itself so that they're not exposed to COVID in unnecessary situations. Make sure that you don't go out for your outings. I know these last 2 years have been very tough and we are all craving for outings. We want to go to the hill stations or maybe just explore the beaches also. But it might be advisable and wiser that if we wait for some more time and delay the COVID third wave so that we are all protected with each other and we stay together and stay happy. So friends, I will again say keep following SMS and help delay the third wave of coronavirus that may or may not come, the God help us. Thank you, dear friends. Take care.